Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. You know, here at Fun Science Demos, we like to say that science is at work all around us. You just have to slow down, take a closer look to find it. Something as simple as a pencil and a glass of water has a lot of science in it. Check this out. I'm going to take the pencil, put it in the glass of water, and take a closer look at what happens. So take a look at my glass and my pencil. It almost looks like the pencil's cut in half. So what's going on? Well, science is going on. Well, the pencil hasn't changed. So why does it look like it's been broken in half? Well, first, we have to figure out how we see things. Through science, we've discovered that we are able to see objects around us because light bounces off of those objects and goes into our eye. We see things because of light. Well, when light travels through air, it travels really, really fast. But when light travels through something like water, that water actually slows the light down, and it does something to that light when it slows it down. Well, through science, we've discovered that when light travels through water, it gets slowed down, and because it slows down, it actually bends. That's why this pencil seems to be broken. So to take a closer look at the idea that light slows down and bends when it goes through water, well, we got ourselves a bigger container of water, and we're going to let this pencil act like light. We're going to hold it above and drop the pencil, and we're going to see how the pencil moves through the air and then how it moves through the water and see if there's a difference between the two. So I'm standing up above our container. I'm going to drop the pencil straight, take a close look at how the pencil travels through the air, and then watch what it does when it hits the water. Here we go. So as the pencil fell through the air, it fell straight. And when it hit the water, it slowed down, and when it slowed down, the path of the pencil bent in the water. That's exactly what light does. Next, we're actually going to try and show you light being bent, but to do that, we need to use a special kind of light. Scientists call it a laser. Remember that most light, like sunlight or light from light bulbs, is scattered all around, but this light is focused into a single beam, so it's really important to never point this in your eye. Because the light from this laser isn't scattered and it's focused in a single beam, we can actually see its path if we shine it through the right material, and the right material happens to be lemon flavored jello. We're going to turn the lights off and zoom in and take a closer look and see what happens to the path of this light in this laser when we pass it through the lemon jello. So we've zoomed in. I have my laser, I have my lemon jello. Let's see if we can see the path the light travels. And you can see my red laser goes right through the jello. Now let's see if we can actually bend this light because it slows down as it goes through the jello, and take a closer look and see if we can get to see the light actually being bent. So we've zoomed in, and I have my laser, and I have my dish of jello, and now to show you the bending of that light, I'm gonna first shoot the laser above the jello in a straight line and hit somewhere around this arrow. Then I'm gonna shine that laser through the jello, and that jello should slow that light down and bend it and move it over somewhere around here. So here we go. I'm gonna shine the laser at the dot, not through the jello. Now I'm just going to drop it down through the jello, and you can see it move over back and forth through the jello. The light bends, and now it's hitting over here. It's hitting there in a straight line, but when it goes through the jello, you can see it bending. Its path bends, and the light is actually moved over. That's exactly why the pencil seemed broken. The water was bending the light by slowing it down. As this light travels through the jello, it slows down and bends and gets moved over. If we look even more carefully, we're gonna notice there's a whole lot of bending going on. It gets bent once as it goes into the jello, as I follow that line, but then as it exits the jello, it gets bent again. That's a lot of bending going on, and that light is being bent as it slows down as it travels through the jello. Something as simple as a pencil and a glass of water can teach us an awful lot about the science behind light. Science is all around us, light is all around us, and sometimes we just need to stop and try to wonder why. If you want to learn more about light, check out our links. Thanks for watching.